off the back. Here we go then, the formation lap is underway ahead of today's sprint. As all the cars take their positions on the grid, the final preparations have been made, and all that's left is for the drivers to deliver on track.
Reducing our overall capacity. The more charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. When you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Okay, you've moved up to P9. Into P9 now, well done. remaining. As things stand, we're going to be leading the championship. Behind is 1.7 seconds. Nice move, keep going.
Despite the best efforts of our championship leader, that lead has taken a bit of a knock today. So then, Ferrari have now moved out of sight and out of reach. It's another triumph for the Italian team as they claim the World Constructors' Championship. Well, that wraps up the sprint.
Formula One returns to Interlagos once again, with the stage set for what promises to be another classic Sao Paulo Grand Prix. Sebastian Vettel famously clinched his third championship here in 2012, and just 4 years later, Max Verstappen treated us to one of the finest wet weather drives of all time. It's an unusual anti-clockwise race here in Interlagos, where the Sao Paulo locals are packed into the grandstands at each of the 15 corners around this classic 2.7-mile circuit. Two very fast sections bookend. So Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary. So as the formation lap gets underway for the last time this season, every driver will be wanting to make sure that they leave a lasting impression on a fabulous season and go out in a winning fashion. As the cars make their way back to the starting grid to form up and get ready for lights out, let's hope the race ahead today is a thrilling one that will go down as a memorable Grand Prix in the history books.
Our overall capacity. The more charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. Okay, we've held position on lap one. That's not great, but it's not terrible. Stay focused. Enabled. clear, green flag. We're approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 6.1 seconds. Okay, our main competitors in this race are Leclerc and Alonso. This lap, please. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track. Need to go the distance. Felipe is coming in for his stop now. Okay, good work. Great pass. Championship. Okay, we've lost a position. That's us down a place. Behind is 11.4 seconds. 5 laps of fuel remaining. Championship.
They've taken the win here. here as we wrap up another fantastic Formula One season. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
As the winners make their way up to the podium, one can only imagine the celebrations that will take place at McLaren tonight. Congratulations to everyone on the team, securing the win and proving that they're a force to be reckoned with out on the track. Our championship leader is still sat at the top of the standings, but their rivals have made up some solid ground today. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give...
We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for the weekend has failed. Any redevelopments will need to be ordered from the R&D screen.